Then blink your lights. Come on, get a waitress over here.
In broad daylight.
Hey, Fonzie.
Hi.
It's his folks car.
Let's go inside and eat. I can't stand being insulted on an empty stomach.
Oh, hey, Trudy.
Betty.
Hi, fellas.
Hi.
Well, how was the funeral?
How about a burger and a malt?
Hey, girls. How about a ride home?
Okay.
Sure. Hey, oh, we could take you home.
Yeah.
We could give you a ride home.
And that?
Thanks, but you might not be going in our direction.
Yeah, we're going forward.
This is a good, strong car. How do they think we got here?
Come on, Rich.
Who are you thinking about taking to the sock hop?
Probably just my socks, unless I can find some wheels.
Listen, why don't you just take your parents' car?
They won't let me use it since I tore the window out at the drive-in. Always remember, before you pull out, take the speaker off.
I suppose we could just take the bus.
Sure. You ever try to tell a girl's mother your bus ran out of gas? We gotta buy some wheels. Hey, how much money you got?
All I have is $100 in my savings.
Hey, we could go 50-50. I got 75.
That's 50-50?
Okay, you can keep the spare tire at your house. Come on, how about it?
You think my father would let me touch my savings for a car?
Well, talk him into it. Use psychology. Tell him if he doesn't let you get a car, you won't eat for a whole day.
I couldn't do that.
Why?
I get a headache if I don't eat.
Oh, Rich.
Watch him, watch him. Look out, ref, he's pulling his hair. Give him the elbow.
Daddy!
Joni, I'm so sorry, sweetheart. But that other guy had a fistful of gorgeous George's curls.
Howard? What happened?
Daddy dented my whole body.
Oh, Daddy didn't mean it, dear. But you should know not to sit close to Daddy when wrestling is on.
I'm sorry, sweetheart. Marion, this will be over in one more fall.
Come and help me in the kitchen, dear, or you'll be the last fall.
Dad?
Look out, he's rubbing soap in his eyes. What's the matter with you, ref? Are you blind? Turn it off, will you, Richie?
Dad, there's something I'd like
to... Those guys aren't athletes, they're actors. The whole thing is phony. The only real person on that whole screen is Captain Mary.
Here, Dad.
What is it, Richie?
Well, Dad, I'm 17, and I think it's time that I learned responsibility.
You want to work in the store?
No, I was thinking more along the lines of transportation.
You want to work on a train?
I want to buy a car.
Oh, Richard. What do you want a car for?
For lots of things. For running errands, for Mom.
Going necking.
I'm sure that's not what Richard wants the car for, Joni.
Mom, Richard's gonna buy a car.
Tell me something. Where do you plan to get the money to buy this rolling den of iniquity?
Oh, we'll see. Potsie and I are going to go in on it together. We've got $175.
How much?
$175.
I always wanted a Cadillac in the family.
It would be nice to have a second car, Howard.
David and Ricky don't have cars. Beaver doesn't have a car. Now, why should our son be any different?
Dad, I know it would be a big responsibility, but that's what you're always saying I need. It'd help me mature. It'd help me learn how to take care of things. You're going to be depending on me someday, you know.
Don't threaten me, Richard.
Howard, at least listen to what he has to say.
Me listen? You know, when I was a kid, my mother used to tell me to listen to my father. Now that I'm a father, my wife tells me to listen to my kids.
A lot of boys Richard's age have their own cars.
Listen, let's just forget I ever even brought it up.
Now, look, Richard, you're old enough to make your own decisions. All I can do is offer you advice. I suggest that you finish high school and college, get yourself a job, and then you'll have enough money to buy yourself a decent car. That's my opinion. But you weigh the pros and the cons, and I'll go along with whatever you decide.
Terrific. I'm going to call Potsie and tell him we can get the car.
I'm glad he's not rushing into this.